Finance Matia Kasaija has been left in disbelief by remarks of President Museveni blasting the ministry he formerly headed as one that harbors corrupt officials. Kasaija, who awaits reappointment to the same ministry, disclosed that there has been syndicated corruption in the ministry during processing of loans. However, members of parliament are not happy at President Museveni's solutions to corruption. Take a look.
Therefore, do not accept the minimalist approach by the Minister of Finance, where the people of Uganda generate wealth that is smaller than the businesses of individual companies in other parts of the world.
The Minister of Finance was a punching bag by President Museveni as he delivered the State of the Nation address at Kololo. Museveni slammed the ministry for breeding corruption.
Corruption has become a real enemy. It starts in the Minister of Finance, where projects are designed with supernumerary elements, extras. They make a project, but they add in things which are not there, which shouldn't be there. These bloated projects go to ministries.
Kasaija was left speechless by Museveni's remarks, but he conceded that the ministry he has led for 5 years is a breeding ground for corruption. He disclosed that there has been syndicated corruption involved in processing of loans.
He has more machinery to detect what's going wrong. I can't deny that's not there. But the challenge is how to break the circle, because these things, people operate in a kind of a circuit. So I can't deny that it's not there. I have said that before. There's some truth, but the biggest problem is how to find out.
He is, however, puzzled that even those systems that have been adopted to fight corruption have been defeated by lack of integrity from those implementing them.
The systems are as good as the people who are operating them. You can put up systems, but if people can break them and cover up, what happens? I'm not saying I'm putting up my hands up. No. That's not the issue. But it's a continuous struggle.
Members of parliament shared their views on the matter.
The president has been addressing the same issues. For example, corruption. He talked about corruption right from 2016. All the president national addresses, he's been addressing about corruption. And this time round, he has talked about the same. So to me, I'm of a view that we walk the talk.
It's really not proper for the president to come and lament and say, people in finance are frustrating me. People frustrated me during Umeme discussions. You know, the thieves are in parliament. The thieves are in Ministry of Finance. The thieves are in police. The thieves are in the judiciary. The president should be directing.
I was saddened, most especially when he made the comment on corruption. I come from a constituency where the youth are scared and have fear in them, in that whenever they go to get jobs, they are always asked, Mwanawani, who are you and where are you from? You know, who are your people? Basically, it's all about connection. Now, when we come here and in President's speech, he emphasizes how he's going to fight corruption by employing daughters and sons of people from prominent families or the rich. He called them DRA, Descendants Resistance Army, Descendants of Resistance Army. So you find there is a total contradiction.
They also commented on the president's outlined steps to fight poverty and insecurity.
As you see now, we need to have commercial agriculture. When you have commercial agriculture, you're able to get food for eating and food for cash, so that you're able to stay well.
He's a father who is calling for hard work for us to develop ourselves. I was just surprised to know that Apple gets more money than Uganda. Apple earns more income than Uganda. I have an Apple iPhone. Many Ugandans do. But did you know that Uganda is as small as a tiny needle in front of Apple in terms of economics? This is a awakening call.
The poverty levels in other places have gone high. And me, who is from a fishing area, Lake Victoria Basin, he has talked about having a very deliberate plan of ensuring that fishing is actually modernized, especially when it will come to cage fishing, when it will come to fishing in ponds. I think this is going to work for the very, very poor.
Meanwhile, the Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, has announced that Parliament of Uganda is to fill one of Uganda's positions in the East African Legislative Assembly, which fell vacant after the death of Mathias Kasamba.